5 F4. Let's look at the store. So there are some new animations in game. This one right here is brand new and it is for Black Bolt. There's also one for Karnak and I believe also for Shield Medic as well. So that, you know, causing a lot of people to speculate that maybe there will be an Inhuman rework. And if there's going to be an Inhuman rework, I'm going to guess that they maybe bring like Medusa and Gorgon to the game. We will see. I don't know. That's purely, you know, speculation, you know, but other characters that got new animations like Psylocke and Vision, like on these loading screens, got reworks. So maybe that's going to be a thing. And then also, I think Tana has a video about War Machine having a new assist animation. So I just feel like that they wouldn't take, you know, they wouldn't take the time to program and make him look a little bit fancier here in the game if they weren't going to rework him. So I don't know when. I mean, it's just speculation, but it's, I guess it's possible that it could be coming anytime. Now I got to give a big shout out to Rocket1420 and Venora for making these amazing infographics. You may have seen already in game, there's a notification that Tower is coming tomorrow. But there's also a Power Broker Bargain. That is going to be an event where you get points for spending gold and winning cosmic crucible battles. So a lot of people are pivoting to be more offense-minded. And then there's also going to be War Inc. Web Milestone. And this is going to be Battle and Alliance War. And then you get extra points for using Underworld. So a lot of people are going to be moving their Underworld, if it's on defense, onto offense. And you do get extra points, like if it is going to be gear tier 15. I think there's thresholds, gear tier 13, gear tier 15, you get more points. And that's going to be on the web store. So that event's going to be starting in a couple days. In addition to that, we're also going to be getting new villain modes, villain nodes, and we're going to be able to farm characters like Phantom X. And then there's also one of the nodes that has Dagger, where you're going to be able to farm training materials. Avengers Tower is coming, Hard Difficulty, Chapters of Villains United, yes, that in Phantom X, Scarlet Spider, Silver Samurai Dagger, and Mighty Thor. And then we're going to have the Arachnid Quick Blitz, where you get extra points using Web Warrior trait. All right, so big shout out to Venora and Rocket 420 for making that infographic. Also, so no gold in the counter for 2 training orbs and 15 T4 training materials. So this, yeah, they actually yanked out like what, over 1 million gold on this month's calendar. And we talked about this a little bit yesterday, but yeah, they used to be like gold and a significant amount of gold, but they've pivoted to towards training materials. Feels to me like they've always do this artificial scarcity thing where they will do like a gold spending heavy event and then give us less gold, more training materials, and then maybe reverse it. It's kind of like they introduce a bunch of mutant characters at the same time, and then it creates some artificial scarcity, or a lot of mystic characters that need to be upgraded, and then you're just like really crunched, and it forces into artificial scarcity to get you to buy stuff. I mean, that's kind of their plan. Our new Eternals, I don't know if they're new, they've been out for a year, are still Mystic Raid meta, absolutely 1,000%. I think the optimal Mystic Raid team right now, without a doubt, is going to be Cersei, Icarus, Dormammu, Morgan Le Fay, and Deathpool, 1,000%. All right, so another thing, this happened last year, and it took a long time to fix. I've reported this to developers already, but the Play Store moved Marvel Strike Force offers again. See how long it's added back this time. It took months last time, and they said it was a Google Play issue, but I don't know. But this happened exactly on the first of the year last year as well. Now we've got some offers to look at. We've got right here an offer for Abomination. He is available in the Cosmic Crucible store along with Hulkbuster and Gambit. So if you want to save some of that currency to maybe get some of the other characters faster, I guess that makes sense. Plus Abomination is a horseman on the Gamma team. He's on the horseman team rather, Gamma. And then you also get 3 red star orbs. So this is reasonable enough. Same thing right here for Gambit, also in the same store. So if you want to save yourself some that currency and get them upgraded faster, I just think that 50 character shards for $5, reasonable value. We've got Echo, and Echo is in the War store. Still pretty important. Young Avengers, I guess. Young Avengers still just seem to be a pretty strong team overall. I kind of had a hard time against them today inside of my Cosmic Crucible. I took Death Seed. I don't think I played it right, but I just posted a video about that Death Seed in Cosmic Crucible And I used him against Young Avengers, and actually it was kind of a scary fight, but I don't think I played it correctly. Goddess of Thunder, we got Mighty Thor. I don't think that Mighty Thor is all that important at this point, but still, again, if you want to save time, 50 character shards for $5. I like that. And then right here, I do not recommend this at all. You know, the technically, you know, Web Warriors replaced Symbiotes, and then Web Warriors are currently being replaced by Rebirth. So, like, this is almost, you know, they're just not really, I'm not using them anywhere right now. I'm not using them in War. I'm not using them in Cosmic Crucible. I mean, they've been reduced pretty much to a Blitz team right now. So I don't recommend the Symbiotes, you know, if you have access to Web Warriors or Rebirth. And then we've got Sharon Carter, 50 character shards for $5. Now, a lot of people have been asking me the question of, have I upgraded any of my skill raid team characters to gear tier 17? And the answer is no. And the reason why not is because we do not have the official word on what the strike members that are going to be as a requirement for Apocalypse. Right now, the only strike member are, and I don't know if it's going to be a team or one team or how many characters, or if it's going to be reworked characters that are already in the game. We just know nothing. The only character that's on that list currently right now is Spider Weaver. Yeah, and but the truth of the matter is, yes, I'm building up an abundance of gear, and that is the hardest node currently in the Doom Raid, without a doubt. And if I knew what the requirements for Apocalypse were going to be, and if they were not going to need this gear, then I absolutely would jump on board with upgrading these characters, because they, you know, those nodes in the Doom Raid are the hardest for me by far. And then we've got one other thing. We got Morbius, 50 character shards for $5. Not that important of a character used on offense versus Heroes for Hire. And now people are definitely mixing up the Heroes for Hire match by throwing in Drax and splitting up the teams in weird patterns so that Morbius is not as useful. There's a different way of playing it now. But anyways, there is Morbius. All right, and then lastly, we've got the giveaway. All right, I really hope you liked this video today, because if you did, you are in luck. For every single person that likes the video, you'll be getting for free in your account an 8-star Black Pink Panther. This is not a scan. Black Pink, I didn't even think about that. That's like a band, right? I have no idea. But look at the eyebrows on this guy. I mean, this is like a Pink Panther done in black, so it's a Black Panther, right? But like even the, this is on point right here for cosplay. Look at how the eyebrows are like floating, like if it was drawn. I like it. Let me know what you think in the comment section. And as always, thanks for watching, and keep on gaming. Bye for now.